Welcome back to the Detailing Business Channel. First of all, let me say thank you, everybody, for the engagement, the subscriptions, the likes, all the comments this year. It's been a lot of fun making these videos for you all and the interaction that's involved. I'm down here in Southwest Florida, going to hang out here for a while and upload some new videos for y'all and enjoy this beautiful weather down here. It's gorgeous. Might hit the pool today. If you're starting a detailing business, I hope you have much success this year. If you're hesitant about starting your detailing business, what are you waiting for? Just get out and do it. You don't have to have all the fancy tools and everything. Just get the products you need, and there's very few products you actually need. You know, you could detail a car with a vacuum, a couple products, and a water hose. You don't even need that if the customer has one. So get out there and get busy. Second, I want to talk about a business opportunity if you've never thought of it. Right now I'm in the mecca of RV resorts. Southwest Florida, there's all kinds. Every 10, 15 miles, there's a high-end RV resort, hundreds and hundreds. Actually, this park has 700 RVs. They're all from up north. They come down here, and as soon as they get here, the first thing they want to do is have their RV at least washed, sometimes waxed. So, major opportunity here. Thousands of RVs need detailed. They'll be here all winter long, and then they'll head back up north when summer comes. So this is a new park to me, but I've been coming to this area in different RV parks for several years, and I've got a feel for the price of a detail. You know, it ranges from, you know, $150 for a wash up to $500, depending on the size of the rig and how detailed. But there's also park models, which is miniature homes here. You know, they need wash too. They'll pay to have those power washed about once or twice a year. So great opportunity down here. If a guy was up north with an established business up north, and wintertime comes, he just brings his detail rig down here, he could continue his business on without a hitch. Making lots of money all winter long, wouldn't have to take a break for the weather. Just an ideal situation if you wanted to be a traveling mobile detailer. Make sure you leave a comment down below and tell me what you think, and if it's a good idea to be a traveling mobile detailer. You know, go where the weather's nice. Isn't that something that would be pretty cool and interesting? I think it would be. Leave a comment, tell me what you think. Anyway, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and I'll see you next time on the Detailing Business Channel.